been telling you about, because this is the first look that the police have at a man they're questioning in the disappearance of missing UVA student Hannah Graham. See that video there? That is him. Leland Vitter is live in Charlottesville, Virginia this morning. Leland, we know what he was doing with her. Do we know what he was doing with her before she vanished?
Well, as far as police are telling us right now, they believe that man was last seen with her at a restaurant nearby the pedestrian mall in downtown Charlottesville. And in the couple of minutes before that, they believe that he put his arm around her as he came up to Hannah Graham there on the mall. 7 days after Hannah Graham disappeared, still no sign of her. And there's 1,100 or so people who are gathering at the local gym here for the UVA sports arena to try and have a massive search party that are going to go out and look for any clues in this. This story has changed so drastically in the past 24 hours. Police know who this person of interest are. Black male, 32 years old, dreadlocks, wearing white. As you can see, they have searched his car. They have searched his apartment, but they say they do not have enough evidence yet to make an arrest in this case. And yesterday, the police chief made a passionate plea for more witnesses to come forward.
This press conference and every press conference hereafter is about one thing and one thing only, and that is finding Hannah. Everyone within the sound of my voice has that responsibility. If you live in the city of Charlottesville, if you attend the University of Virginia, if that young lady's touched your life in any way, you have the responsibility to help us find her.
And so many people who didn't know her say that they do feel that responsibility to come out and find her. It has now been 1 week exactly since she vanishes. A lot of the searchers we have talked to today say they are scared about what they might find in this case. On the other hand, I talked to a number of young women who are out here and said, well, this could have very easily been us. We walk the same streets every night, and if we disappeared, we would want someone out searching for us, and that's why we're going to spend our Saturday doing that. Meantime, police say they're going to be canvassing local businesses and trying to find more surveillance tape, also looking at cell phone records, those kinds of things, to see if they can't get enough evidence about this person of interest to try and make an arrest in the case. Guys, back to you.
All right. Thanks a lot, Leland.
Thanks, Leland.
I gotta say, I spent an awful lot of time in Charlottesville, Virginia. I'm going there tomorrow. I've never seen a place with more aggressive panhandlers and homeless people ever.
And you describe,
they're threatening, really threatening. And I've always wondered why the police put up with that there.
And you described part of the walk from that, from campus to that mall area, as going through some pretty seedy parts of town, right underneath the bridge and where there's panhandlers.
Yeah, but again, it's just like any place. If you put up with drunk people getting in your face and grabbing at you and demanding money, and they do put up with it down there, you know, I mean, it makes it a threatening place.
Well, and it is scary. At least four girls have gone missing or murdered there in the last 5 years.
Troubling.
They need to follow this story. Hopefully this has a happy ending and not a sad one.